Hi guys, welcome back to another amazing episode of Gossip Feud with Fola. Actually, I want to send a very big apology to you guys because I have not been consistent lately. And also, I want to say happy Eid to my Muslim brothers and sisters out there. And of course, I have a gift for you. Story of today's episode is about the President Muhammadu Buhari, who took to his social media handle to say Nigeria knows we have tried our best in combating insecurity. Although this post got a lot of reactions on social media, and of course I can read you some of the comments. First comment I'll be reading out is somebody said, Tobaya Mwani, we are talking anyhow to the government. They won't see how the federal is talking anyhow now. Please lying. There is another comment. Somebody said, if that is the case, what is happening in Southern Kaduna? Why the recent attack on Borno governor and so many others? I beg, change your dealer, Bubu. There is another comment. Somebody said, useless, weak, shameless old man. He has lost his senses. Should I have said this comment is too much? From a troll to the president of Nigeria. Most of Nigerians, they are only good at typing on social media, but when it comes to taking action physically, we are nowhere to be found. This is one of the reasons why I believe it makes the president to also refer the youth as lazy youth. Another person says, who is we? We don't know anything. The only thing we know is that every person for themselves when it comes to protection and security. And that on period. It is believed that security in Nigeria is nothing to write home about. Though the Nigeria police force are trying their best, but I think more effort should be put in place to save more lives and properties. Also, if we all remember sometimes in 2019 when Senator Abbo assaulted a woman in a sex toy shop. Well, it was reported then that the case was in court. But it was so funny to announce that the case has been dismissed by the court.
Drop your phone.
She's talking to her father.
I said drop your phone now, I'm talking. You called him, but nobody's arresting you.
Drop the phone.
Oh,
God.
You're very stupid.
Oh, God, mistake it easy now.
You are very stupid. You are very stupid. You are very stupid. I think you're very stupid. I've been coming to you. Are you mad? I know where you go. I think you're very stupid.
Take
her. Go with her.
It really breaks my heart, despite the viral video showing where Senator Abbo assaulted the woman in a sex toy shop. It was reported that the court has dismissed this case, saying the police have failed to prove beyond reasonable doubt that Senator Abbo has truly assaulted this woman. Imagine there is a video, of course, and this video went viral. As a matter of fact, there was a televised press conference in which Senator Abbo apologized to this woman for assaulting her, only for the magistrate to say the police had failed to prove beyond reasonable doubt that the woman was truly assaulted. Although this post also got a lot of reactions on social media, because I would like to read you some of the comments. Yeah, the first person said, all these things are not funny, but most people still find it very funny. I weep for the coming generation. We believe we're running a lawless country, because when something was on tape and the video went viral, only for the magistrate to dismiss the case. Like, is it because this man is a senator? Because he's also one of the lawmakers? There's another comment. Somebody said, You see, one of the reasons this country can't move forward, dismissing a clear court case, rubbish. You can imagine when something was on tape and it went viral, even the alleged senator also apologized. Then why can't the court also take its course? Here's another comment. Somebody said, this is justice in Nigeria. Once you have money, you are always right. A rich person can do no wrong in Nigeria. You can imagine that, so sad, as in it portrays Nigeria to be a lawless country. And here's another comment. Somebody said, if it was an ordinary Nigerian now, this useless court or judge would be blind to law and sentence the person to 20 years in jail. This country, now have money and commit any kind of crime and you will walk freely. This is so sad. Like, how, what are we even portraying as a Nigerian? Like, they believe Nigeria can only be free for the rich, for the wealthy people. But once you are poor like this, you are not living. Look at what this man said. Like, once you have money and you commit crime, of course you can walk freely. There is another comment. Somebody said, can they all have COVID and not get well? Wicked and unrepentant fools. Imagine somebody is wishing the judge and the court and whoever involved in the manipulation of the court case, somebody is wishing them COVID-19. The last story on today's episode of Gossip Feed with Fola is about one Prophet Chukwu, who had cried out urging federal government to please shut down Big Brother Naija.
Nigerian government did not shut BB Naija down. I will shut them down by force. With my spiritual capability, I can do it. I know who I am. I'm not a prophet that is boasting. With my spiritual level, I will destroy BB Naija. I will use my name, my mouth, my spiritual power on them. So it's better for you people to close them down, because they are consuming the mind and destroying the mind of our children.
I don't know what you think about Big Brother Naija, but whatever you think about it, please let us know in the comment section. Don't forget to subscribe to this YouTube channel. You can share, like, and also drop your opinion in the comment section. This is where I'll be wrapping it up on today's episode of Gossip Feud with Fola. Until the next time I'll be popping up on your screen, please stay safe.